What is the full form of DDL? Data.
Destination language.
Nation. Language. Okay. So in data definition language, commands. So inside of your databases, okay, inside of your database, you have the table, right? Whatever the table data is, that whatever the data objects, the information, it is stored in table format, right? So inside of your table, you want to create a table. The TDL command examples, create table, right? Alter table. And delete table. Create table, alter table, and delete table. For example, you want to create a table inside of your database. You want to create a table. What is the syntax? Okay, in SQL commands, whenever you are writing, whatever the keywords there related to SQL related, that keywords you can write in capital letters. That is a good one. Okay. The first one, you want to create any database. Okay, so if you want to create any database, you can use the command create table. Sorry, create space table, then table name. So here inside of this you can write your columns, how many columns you want inside of your table, how many columns you need. Then column name space data type comma column to data type column 3 data type. Like that you can take it as an n number of columns instead of your table. Okay, so whenever, so as of now we know only two data types, one is an into type, one is a var canon. Whenever you want to store the data inside of your records, that is a numbers, you can use an into data type. That is a text. Okay, you can use an varchar. Right? So that is a varchar. That is a text. You can use an varchar. Okay. Now you open your JAMP server first. Hello. Okay, so inside of your server you can use JAMP server. So in this JAMP server, go to and down, you can open JAMP control. Double click, it will open one window. Inside of that window, you need to start one Apache and MySQL. Okay, so you need to start Apache and MySQL. Okay, Apache and MySQL. Then after you can click on admin button. Now your servers are started, Apache and MySQL, then click on admin button. It is directly open. Inside of whatever the default browser you selected, the default browser is open, localhost slash PHP MyAdmin. Right? So inside of this, whatever the commands you want, right? Right. For example, you taken one example. Okay, this is your database, assume. So inside of this, in previous sessions, we created a manually. Now you want to create the table by using of commands, by using of SQL commands. Okay, go to an SQL, write down here your table comment. So if you want to create table, just you can use the keyboard create. Next you are creating the table, right? So that's why we are taking some table. What is the table, your table name? Okay, you want what is the table name. So I want my table name is in students, so that's why I'm taking as in students. Okay, inside of my table, how many number of fields you need? You need how many fields inside of your table? Okay, so I want the student ID. Then ID is an int type, so I am taking as an int, comma. Okay, what is the syntax of your table creation? First column name, then data type. Right, column 2 and data type. Column 3 and data type. Right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So like that you also need to write. So you want to write one more column. Student name. Then data type. Student name is citizen varchar. Right? Okay. So whenever you are taking the type is an varchar, at the time compulsory. Okay, so at the time compulsory you need to take it is in size also in important. Okay, so inside of varchar you want to mention the size, you can use some brackets. Inside of that you can make the count. How many characters? I need a 40 characters. Next, you want one more column. Comma, student number. Okay, so you want varchar or you want int? Depends. So I need an int. Take it as an int. Next, you need a varchar. Whatever the data is there, that data you want an email. Student email. Okay, so that is also varchar. Varchar. Whenever you are taking the varchar, compulsory you need to mention the size. How many characters you want to store? So 50 characters, and so I am making this in 50 characters. Then you can click Alt Enter, or otherwise you can go and click on Go button. Okay, either you can click on Alt plus Enter directly after that Go button will be automatically pressed, or otherwise you can go and click. Okay, so it is getting now table created. Just observe here, it is created the event table. Okay, so this is an example. For your table creation. Okay, you now as of now created one student table. Inside of the student table, I want to add one more field. Okay, so the student is learning which course I want to add. Technology I want to add. And batch number I want to add. Right? So you need to alter the
DDL command. Where sir already? DDL commands which appears are ela create cheyalani.
అలర్ట్ చెప్పారు
ఆ చెప్పారు సార్ నిన్న డిడిఎల్ అయిపోయాయి అని చెప్పారు ఎలా క్రియేట్ చేయాలి అని
ఓకే ఓకే నో ప్రాబ్లం మళ్ళీ రఫ్ గా చెప్పేస్తాను వినండి ఓకే ఓకే ఇవి మొత్తం కంప్లీట్ అయ్యా మీకు
డిడిఎల్ వి అన్ని చెప్పారు సార్ క్రియేట్ టేబుల్ ఆల్టర్ టేబుల్ డిలీట్ కాలమ్ చేంజ్ ఇన్సైడ్ ద కాలమ్స్ మోడిఫై అవి చెప్పారు సార్
ఓకే ఓకే నో ప్రాబ్లం మళ్ళీ ఒకసారి బ్రీఫ్గా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తా మైండ్ లో పెట్టుకోండి ఓకేనా
ఓకే
నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఆల్టర్ టేబుల్ సో దిస్ ఆల్టర్ టేబుల్ వి ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఫర్ వెనెవర్ యు వాంట్ టు change inside of your fields. For example, you want to add one more fields. Okay. So you want to add one more fields inside of your table. More fields inside of your table. Okay, so inside of your table you want to add one more, just you can use the command alter. Okay, alter table name for example table name is a student sorry table name okay so alter table name space you are adding the one more column right so just use the add keyboard and add your column name okay whatever the column name you want add that column name with the data type okay column name with the data type So you want to add the column and just add and column whatever the column name you want write down that column name column and data okay the second so now I am adding the one more column just also go to your SQL alt table okay then table name is students okay so you are adding one more column add okay you want to add the student batch student batch number space this batch number is an int type so you can take it as an int okay so I want to add the technology also course name space which data type where can how many fields you want to store okay 20 characters So here if you add the multiple columns at a time you are getting the compilation error right so at that cases you can just use after add is completed then you can use a semicolon okay then after you can use the same one more time okay so end with semicolon then start one more statement right so just click on go button or otherwise you can click on alt plus enter so go and check once the two statements are right student batch number and course okay now here also I will check once columns next okay so whenever you are altering the table in you want to delete that field for example that student batch number no need I want to delete okay so just you can use the drop same as it is if you want to delete column inside the table inside the table you can use below command Okay, the command name is an alter table name. So now you are doing the draw, right? Draw. What you are dropping the column, right? So write down the column. Okay. Then column name. I don't know column name. So now it will tell it you. Okay, so just I'm writing now an example. Same alter table, table name, okay, the table name is students. Instead of this I want to draw column, write down the column name, student, batch number I want to be, okay, and with semicolon, then click on go. Okay, do we want delete? Okay. So now your student has been deleted, just object, right? Student number is not there now. Next, okay, now you want to add or delete is done. So for example, you want to modify that data type, okay, inside of your table, whatever the column you have taken, the column you want to modify, you can use okay alter table name, sorry, table name, okay, alter table name, then modify, okay, so what you want to modify particular column name with the data type. Column name and data. Okay, column name and data. Okay. So in course name, I want to change an varchar to into data. Now it is an varchar, right? So I want to change an into data type. Can write alter table name is an students, okay. So which table which field you want to modify, write down your column name. Course name I want to change. Okay. Course name I want to change an into type. Okay. Like that you can modify that fields. Next. We want to delete the table. Okay, you can use and drop the table. Delete table, you can use the drop, then table you are deleting, so write down the table, then table name is a students, right? So write down table name. Okay, so this structure. Now I want to delete this employees table. Okay, this employee table I want to delete. just write down here. Drop table, then table name is an implies. Enter. Okay. The table was deleted. Just observe here, the only students table is there. Okay, so next DML. What is the full form of DML? Data
Manipulation Language.
Correct. So now this is a data manipulation language. In data manipulation language, so in data manipulation language you can get data. So inside of your table you want to insert a new record, you want to insert a new row data, you want to insert, right? So that purpose we are using this data manipulation language. Insert a data or update a data or delete a data. Okay, so inside of your table you want to insert a new record, or you want to delete that particular record, or you want to update any one field inside of that. Okay, one field value you want to update. Okay, the first one DML. Okay, instead of DML we have create a table, sorry, insert a record, insert, update, delete, right? So the first one, if you want to insert your data inside of your table, insert your data inside the table, you can use insert into . So inside of our database you have the multiple table, right? So which table you want to insert, write down your table name, okay, space, no need of space, table name along with your column names, okay, column 1 column 2 and whatever the column, third column is there, column 3. Like that you can take it as an n number of columns. Okay, inside of the first column you want to insert the values, right? So then you can use an values. Okay, so inside of this you can use an what is the value you want, right? column 1 column 2 column 3, right? So inside of this column you can use value 1. Okay, the first column, the first value, second column, second value, third column, third value, fourth column, fourth value. Sorry, here we have the only duplicate, right? So 3 values, and you written multiple here also, you can take it as a multiple. Okay, this is one option, and you can insert direct values also inside of your table. Directly you can insert into table name and write down here what is the table name, right? Insert into whatever the table you taken, that particular table name, value 1, value 2, value 3. Like that you can take it as an n values directly. But here whatever the inside of your table, whatever the column name you taken, the column name should be match compulsory. Okay, so now I'm writing on exam. Instead of your students table, you want to insert a value. Okay, first. Okay, so what are the field names are there? Just first check once. Okay, so instead of your table, you have the student ID, student name, student number, and student email and course name. Right? So you want to store the all the values or one or two fields. That is on your choice. Okay, first I want to take, if you want to insert a data, you can use insert into. What is the table name? Is there a table name to take here? Students is a table name. Take the students. Inside of this, which course you are taking? Like, what is the fields are there? Student ID is there, student name, student number, student email, and courses. Okay, course name, space, values. Right, instead of this, you can use in based on data type, ID is an int type, you can need to give an one. Next, student name is a varchar, right? Whenever you are taking as a varchar, you can take it as an either single quotations or quotes. Okay, as of now, I am taking as a single quotes. Whatever the value you are taken based on the particular data type, you can mention. So, varchar is a text, right? So, we can store it within a single quotes. So, within a single quotes, write down that student name. Manisha is a student, comma, next student number, mobile number we are taking, okay. Next, comma, email, Manisha, it is also in varchar, right, so varchar you can put it in within a single place, Manisha at the rate gmail.com. Right. Next mail is done. Next course name. Okay, course name is also varchar. So as of now, we taken as an int type. So this time I'm giving the number code of course code I'm giving. Okay, one. Then click on go. Okay. So now it inserted one record. Okay, one row is inserted. Right. Just browse, click on browse here. Whatever the record, even the record is inserted now. You want to insert by using of values, okay? That is also possible. Values insert into okay. Whatever the table name you've taken, the table name, students is our table name, students, then write down, first we are taking the ID, right, student ID, student name, okay, Rajeshwari, right, and next student number, next email, Rajeshwari at the rate gmail.com. Okay, comma email, which email? After number email, then course name. Okay, course is an number event. That is in the data type, so we can take a number. Then click on. Okay, here we have the error. You have an error in syntax. Okay, so insert into return type. Then after you need to write the values here. After students, you can write in values, right? Directly you are adding the values. So you can take it as in students space values. Okay, here also I missed the values here. Okay, so values. Then you can insert your record. Directly you can insert the record by using the values also possible. Okay, this is one example. That is one example. Sir, you want to, it is possible to insert a multiple records in a time. Okay, that is also possible. Just you can use the same command with comma. Okay, so you want to insert one more. Just take a comma. Okay, you want one more record? Like n number of, you can take the multiple records. Okay, Rajeshwari and Maheshwari. Someshwari. Okay. Next, Kalyani. Okay. So like that you can insert multiple records also possible at a time. Just go here, checkpoints. All the records are inserted, right? Like that you can insert multiple records also is possible. Now you want to update in Rajeshwari's place, you want to update that particular name. Okay, so here you can change the names. Okay, so here you can give the your ID, whatever the student ID is there, that student ID you can give an uniqueness. Okay, and you can change the numbers also otherwise. 1, 2, 3, like that. So you want to give the auto increment is also possible. In the first session I explained by selecting the AI. Okay, now it is not possible because we are already inserted the duplicates. Okay, so you can take either new or otherwise you can use them this one. Okay, next you want to update any field inside of your record. For example, in Maheshwari place, the whatever the student ID is, then that student ID I want to change 2 to 3. Okay, so you want to update the field, update the field value. Okay, so first you can take it as an update. First you can take it as an update. This is the keyword, right? So you can write in progress letter update. Okay, inside of the table you are updating, right? So write down your table name. Whatever the table name is, the table name, then give the space and use the keyword set. Okay, then use the keyword set and column, name you need to write. Column name is equal to what you want to change. Okay, write down within a single quotation what you want to change. Value. Okay, whatever the new value you are taking, that new value you can take here. You want to change the multiple updates in a single time, that is also possible. Instead of even one record, you want to change the column name, multiple columns like student ID along with a student number. Okay, so you want to change, that is also is possible. Multiple also is possible, comma, then take it as a column name too. Okay, whatever the column name you take, write down that column name is equal to value 2, then set column 2, and then you can write the where class here. Where. So inside of your table you have the multiple records, right? But you want to change which record, first record or second record or third record, which record you want to change. So that's why we are using a where class here. Where, whatever the column name is, that column name is equal to, in within a single quotation you can take that particular column name. Okay, one or two, you are taking. So for example, you are taking column name, which column name you want, so write down that particular value. Okay, then end with a semicolon. Okay, so first I am updating the only one value, so just to this two value in my query place I want to change 3. Okay, just go. What is the command, tell me? First you need to use the which keyword you want to update. Hello,
update table name set
here. What is our table name?
Students.
Students is our table name.
Students set
students. Next, which keyword we are using?
Column name
set. First set. Okay, then after you can write your column name. So inside of student ID I want to change. Student ID is equal to, I want to change the 3. Okay, in which record you want to stay? Inside of your table you have the multiple records, right? So you want to change which record, so that's why we are using a where class. Where the student name is matched with Maheshwari. Okay, inside of my table whatever the student name is matched with in my SVT, you can update that student ID as a 3. Okay, then click go. Okay, 0 rows are affected. 0 rows means it is not a correct. Okay, but the reason is whatever the name you given, that name is not matched. I think Maheshwari, the spelling is mistake is there. Here S is not there. Okay, I'm writing one more time. Let's go, sir. First update, then table name students, then set keyword, then column name is on student ID is equal to 3. Where, okay, student name is matched with Maheshwari. Okay, here S is missing. Okay, that's why in the previous example we will get the. Okay, now click on here, just check one row is empty. Okay, so now you updated only one field. Just observe. it is changed or not. Okay, the MySQL class. For example, this where class you missed. Okay, so whatever the where class is, that where class you are missing. This 3 is updated to all the records. Okay, how many rows are effective? 4 rows. Inside of your table, 4 rows are there, that's why 4 rows are affected. For example, 4000 records are there. Total 4000 records is changed to T. Whatever the ID is there, inside of that ID, all the records it have the same name. This comes to 3. Right? Like that, you want to update whenever you are updating at that time, just check once and then update. Okay, so you are changing which record inside of your table. I have, you have that lot of records, and that you need to change which record, that is an important. So that's why we are reaching that where class. Okay, now you want to update that particular, for example, you want to delete this total records. Okay, so inside of your table, you want to delete wherever the Manisha is, that Manisha record, I want to delete. Okay, you can use the command delete so table name. So if you want to delete a table, instead of your record, you want to delete only one particular record, right? So at that cases, you can use delete, then table name, and where condition. Where condition you can write here. Condition means like that. So based on that condition, it will delete it. So here we return the one condition. Inside of my table, my SRE, wherever it is matched, you can update that value. Value is 3. Right? So here also you can write the condition. This is also in one condition, right? Wait. Okay, delete where, delete. For example, here also you didn't return where condition. All the records will be deleted. Okay, for example, now I want to delete only this Manisha record. Okay, so write down the command delete, table name is students. Okay, students, then which table you want to delete? So where student name is equal to Manisha. Sorry, we missed one keyword, from. Okay, delete from table name. Here also we need to take the delete from. Okay, which table you want to delete? Delete from table name, then where and condition. Okay, so delete from whatever the table name is, the table name where student name is equal to Manisha. Okay, now observe. Okay, the Manisha record is deleted. For example, you want to delete all the records. You just remove this where class, automatically deletes all the records. Okay, so all the records are deleted. 4 rows. You can browse here. Inside of your table, you don't have any records. Okay. For example, you missed that where class, here also all the rows are deleted, or all the records are deleted. Okay, clear? Is there any doubt?
Clear, sir. సార్ ఇప్పుడు ఈమెయిల్ ఐడిలో నెంబర్స్ కూడా ఉంటాయి కదా సార్, అప్పుడు ఈమెయిల్ ఐడి వార్కార్ తీసుకోవాలా ఇంటి తీసుకోవాలా?
వార్కార్
మన నెంబర్
వార్కార్ లో అన్ని స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, మీరు నెంబర్స్ స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, టెక్స్ట్ స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు.
ఓకే సార్,
ఇంటి ఇస్తే మాత్రం ఓన్లీ నెంబర్స్ స్టోర్ చేసుకోవాలి.
సార్ ఒకవేళ ఇమేజెస్ స్టోర్ చేసుకోవాలనుకుంటే?
ఇమేజెస్ ఇక్కడ స్టోర్ చేయను, మనకు డేటాబేస్ కి సపరేట్ గా ఫైల్ మేనేజర్, ఇప్పుడు మనకు సిస్టమ్ కి ఫైల్ మేనేజర్ ఉంది అవును. ఈ ఫైల్ మేనేజర్ లో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈ వీడియో ఉంది, ఈ వీడియోని డేటాబేస్ లో స్టోర్ చేస్తే ఏమవుతుందంటే లోడ్ ఎక్కువ పడుతుంది. దానికోసం మనం ఏం చేస్తామంటే జస్ట్ దీని యొక్క పాత్ ని అక్కడ స్టోర్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఓకే, దీని యొక్క పాత్ అంటే నేమ్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఆ నేమ్ తో పాటు ఈ టోటల్ పాత్, టోటల్ పాత్ అయినా స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, లేకపోతే ఓన్లీ నేమ్ అయినా స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. అది దాన్ని తీసుకొని ఇక్కడ నుంచి మనం ఒకటి ప్లే చేస్తాం. అంటే ఇవైకి వచ్చేసరికి అల్టిమేట్గా ఇవై ఫైల్లో ఎలా ప్లే చేస్తున్నా, మనం వీడియోస్ యూజ్ చేసినప్పుడు ఆ ఫైల్ యొక్క పాత్ ఎస్ఆర్సీ దగ్గర ఫైల్ పాత్ ఇస్తే ఆటోమేటిక్ ఏమవుతుంది, ఆ వీడియో ప్లే అవుతుంది కదా. సో డేటాబేస్ నుంచి వచ్చినప్పుడు ఆ ఫైల్ యొక్క పాత్ని ఆ ఎస్ఆర్సీ లోపల మీరు ఇస్తే ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఆ వీడియో ప్లే అవుతుంది. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మీరు ఇమేజ్ తీసుకున్నారు, ఆ ఇమేజ్ యొక్క పాత్ అనేది మెన్షన్ చేస్తే అప్పుడు వచ్చేస్తుంది. డేటాబేసెస్లో మనం ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఏంటంటే ఓన్లీ పాత్ మాత్రమే స్టోర్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఆ ఫైల్స్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో, మీడియా ఫైల్స్ అవ్వచ్చు లేకపోతే పీడిఎఫ్ ఫైల్స్, ఫైల్స్ అన్నింటిని కూడా ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఫైల్ మేనేజర్లోనే స్టోర్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఇప్పుడు మీరు ఈవెన్ ఇప్పుడు మనకు లోకల్ ఫైల్ మేనేజర్ యూజ్ చేసుకుంటాం, మీరు అదే ఇదర్ గోడాట్లో కానీ వెయిట్లో కానీ హోస్టింగ్ తీసుకుంటే అక్కడ కూడా ఫైల్ మేనేజర్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, సో అక్కడ కూడా ఫైల్ మేనేజర్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఆ ఫైల్ యొక్క పాత్ర మాత్రం మనం ఈ ఎస్క్యూఎల్ డేటాబేస్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఆ డేటాబేస్ లోపల స్టోర్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఇమేజెస్ను కూడా స్టోర్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, కానీ మీ యొక్క సర్వర్ ఏదైతే ఉందో అది చాలా టైం తీసుకుంటుంది. ఇప్పుడు నీకు టెక్స్ట్ కాబట్టి త్వరగా వచ్చేస్తుంది ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్, అందులో నీకు ఇమేజ్ ఉంది అనుకోండి, సో ఆ ఇమేజ్ మొత్తాన్ని బయట ఫార్మేట్లో మొత్తం రీడ్ చేయాలంటే ఎక్కువ టైం తీసుకుంటుంది. 4 MB 5 MB ఉంటుంది ఒక్కొక్క ఎంబీ లీస్ట్ అన్న కానీ, సో ఆ ఎంబీ మొత్తం రీడ్ చేయాలి, అదే టెక్స్ట్కి అంతా ఉండదు. కాబట్టి ఎప్పుడు కూడా మనం ఏంటంటే ఇమేజెస్ని అందులో స్టోర్ చేసుకోం, ఇమేజెస్ యొక్క పాత్ర మాత్రమే స్టోర్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఆ పాత్ర మళ్ళీ మనం HTML డిస్ప్లే చేస్తాం.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
సో ఒకసారి మీరు అంతా ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయండి అన్నీ, ఒకసారి మీకు క్లారిటీ అనేది వస్తుంది. ఓకే, అందరు క్లియర్ కదా? మళ్ళీ ఇంకోసారి ఏమైనా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్
చేయాలి, అప్డేట్ ది సింటాక్స్ చూపించారా సార్?
ఓకే, అప్డేట్ ఫ్రమ్, సారీ అప్డేట్ దెన్ టేబుల్ నేమ్ సెట్ కాలమ్ నేమ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు వాల్యూ, న్యూ వాల్యూ అగైన్ కాలమ్ నేమ్ వాల్యూ. ఓకే, ఇది వేర్ కండిషన్ అంటే మీరు ఇక్కడ ఏదైతే కండిషన్ రాస్తున్నారో ఆ కండిషన్ బట్టి డిలీట్ అవుతుంది. మీ ఉన్న రికార్డ్స్లో దేన్ని మీరు డిలీట్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారు, లేకపోతే దేన్ని మీరు అప్డేట్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారు, ఏ నేమ్తో మ్యాచ్ అవుతుంది, ఏ ఫీల్డ్తో మ్యాచ్ అవుతుందో ఆ దాన్ని మాత్రమే డిలీట్ చేయచ్చు, లేకపోతే దాన్ని మాత్రమే అప్డేట్ చేస్తారు. ఓకే, క్లియర్ కదా?
Yes sir, clear.
ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయండి, ప్రాక్టీస్ చేసినవి ఒకసారి మీ డ్రైవ్లో కూడా, మీకు ఆల్రెడీ డ్రైవ్ ఒకటి క్రియేట్ చేశాను కదా, ఆ డ్రైవ్లో కూడా పెట్టేసేయండి.